Hey guys, this is Panachan. I know it's a little late for this, but Happy New Year. And today I'm going to teach you guys how to make mochi. So let's go to the kitchen. Alright, so today I'm going to show you guys how to make mochi, and here's what you're going to need. Alright, you guys want to make sure you're using a microwave safe bowl, and the rice flour I'm using is Meat Mochiko, and I got this at my local Asian grocery store. So if you're in the Pittsburgh area like I am, you can go either to Lotus or to the Asian Food Market in Monroeville behind Elmer's Pet Store and Aquarium. That's where I got this. And the same place I also got my red bean paste. It came out of a can and then I froze it to keep it safe after I opened it. So anyway, let's get started. So take your rice flour and then just dump it in the bowl like so. And then you're gonna add the sugar. And you're just gonna get a whisk and mix it together real good. Fortunately, I only have one free hand, so it might take longer than I would like for it to. All right, so once you mix together the sugar and the rice flour really nicely, then you're going to add the water. You add it little by little, add in about three parts. And then you're going to need a rubber spatula to kind of mix it all together. Until you get one consistency. And like I said, because I only have one free hand, it's going to be a little harder for me than it should be for you. But I'm not worried. Now, after you've added all the water, if it looks a little too soupy, feel free to add some more rice flour. I'll show you what the consistency should look like afterwards. I'm just going to add the last part. Anyway, when you're done, you should have a consistency kind of like this, a soupy mashed potato kind of like texture. And I've had a lot of trial and error with this recipe from the measurements it gave me. So don't be alarmed if yours comes out very watery. Just add, you know, more rice flour until you get a consistency like this. But the measurements I gave you in the beginning are a good start. So anyway, like I said, you're going to make sure you're doing this in a microwave safe bowl. It's very important because you're going to be using the microwave. So next, you're going to put your bowl in the microwave and then you're going to set the time for 1 minute. Right, once it's done, it should look a little something like this. I'll take the same spatula you had and just get it wet, preferably with warm water. I just feel like it'll be better if you use warm water and not cold. And just, you know, stir it around real good, you know, mix it up. You know, it's gonna be thicker in some places than others, so just mix it around really good and thoroughly. Alright, I got it mixed up really well. So then when you're done, make sure that you wipe as much as possible off of the spatula, so just wipe it off on the sides so you don't lose precious mochi. put it back in the microwave for another minute and let it go. All right, this is what it looks like after the second microwaving. And you're just gonna do the same thing you did before. You're gonna wet the rubber spatula and stir it up real good one more time. And then we're gonna put it back in the microwave. All right, this is the last time, but instead we're gonna put it in for only 30 seconds. It's the last time you'll have to microwave it. All right, now it should look something like this. And this is where the cornstarch is gonna come in. Now you see, this stuff is really, really sticky. So if you don't use cornstarch, you're not gonna be able to even make the mochi because it's gonna be all over your hands and all over whatever plate you're using. I already have my plate powdered with the starch. And then you have to put some on the mochi itself. Now, if you have a sifter, it's gonna be a lot easier, but of course I can't use it because I need at least, I need two free hands in order to use it. So if you don't have a sifter, it's okay. Just sprinkle the mochi, the cornstarch on the mochi. You are going to need a generous amount, and I like to use the rubber spatula. Distribute it all over. I know it may seem like a lot, but it's necessary. Well, actually, I don't think I'll need any more than this. So just, spread it all over. And we're gonna get ready to actually make the mochi itself. Right, so get you some mochi and make it into like a little flat patty, just like this here, about that size. And then you are going to take your red bean paste, get a spoon, and get just a little bit. You don't need nearly as much as you think you do, or else you're not going to be able to close up the mochi. Just put a little bit there, it'll come off. Maybe just a little bit more. Yeah, that's good. That's probably more than enough. And then you're just going to take all the corners and fold them over. Like I said, it'd be easier if I had two free hands. But pretty much you're just going to take this and fold it over. Take these two sides and fold it over. And you'll kind of mold it together. Kind of press it together with both hands. Not really hard, because if you do it too hard, then the red bean paste is gonna burst out. So it's kind of like you want to mold together good, but delicately. Okay, when you're done, it should look something like this. Now, if it starts to stick to your hands in the process of molding it, it's perfectly okay, perfectly normal to need more cornstarch. Just scoop some up, put in your hand, to get rid of that sticky consistency. Because like I said, this stuff is super sticky. Even if you don't powder it efficiently in one spot, it's going to mess up the whole process. So if you have done this recipe correctly, or if you're making your mochi in, fair sizes, you should be able to make about 6 of these. Okay, so I was actually able to make 9 instead of 6. Probably because my consistency was very soupy in the beginning, so I had to add some more rice flour. So it actually was a lot, and enough to make 9 instead of 6. So, yeah. Well, that's it for now. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe so you can see more later on. And until next time, Panachon out. Peace.